In this video, I'm gonna show you how to set up and play Crash Team Racing online. You heard it right, it is now possible to play the original CTR online up to 8 players. This is insane. There's even a in-game online menu now where you can select the server and check the rooms available and start playing. And I'm just shocked that such thing is possible now. Anyway, this video will cover everything you need to play this as well, so let's get started. We're gonna start by downloading Duckstation. I'm going to put the link of this website on the description of the video, and this is one of the best PS1 emulators out there, and it is required for playing Gran Turismo 2 in the way I'm gonna show you. I'm using Windows 10, so I'm gonna click here on the Windows version of this, and it says here that Duckstation requires VC++ runtime to be installed. And if you don't have that on your PC, Duckstation will tell you when you try to install it. So if it does happen to you, first you have to download VC++ by clicking on this link, and then just run the .ex setup, install everything, and you're good to go. And from there, just click here on Download Duck and place the files on the place of your preference on your PC. It will come as a zip file right here, so first we need to extract using WinRAR or 7-zip, that's up to you. It's very straightforward, just select the program you're using and click on extract here, and it will generate the files from the emulator. Go ahead and delete the original zip file, we don't need it anymore. And before we start setting up the emulator, I'm gonna recommend you here to create 2 folders inside this emulator folder. One is called BIOS and the second one is called Games, just so that we keep things organized moving forward. Now we can start the Duckstation installation. So just double click here on duckstation.ex file. It's going to open the setup wizard. First, it's going to ask you what language you want to use for the emulator, selecting the default theme for it. I'm gonna leave mine as Dark Fusion Gray, and also leave enable automatic updates available. Click on next. Here, it's going to ask you where you want the emulator to scan for the BIOS files. And I can't show you here on the video how to get them because it's against YouTube's policy. But it shouldn't be hard to find on the internet, if you know what I mean. And when you do, make sure that you get the American BIOS. That is version 5501. And as you probably have guessed already, you're gonna place the BIOS on that same BIOS folder that we just created right here. So in my case, I'm gonna paste my BIOS file here and we're good to go. So now go back to the Duckstation setup wizard and we're gonna change the scan directory here. By default, it's going to be this one. So just click here on Browse and it should open the same folder where the emulator is installed. So you just have to highlight the BIOS folder, then click on Select and leave everything else as default. Now you're gonna click on Next again. And this time it's going to ask you where you want the emulator to scan for the games, which is the games folder that we just created. So click here on add and then highlight the games folder and click on select folder. This window will show up, click on yes, and there you go. You can now click here on next. Finally, we have the controller set up. And if you don't have your controller connected yet, go ahead and do that now. And this emulator has an automatic mapping function here, which is pretty good. So you just have to click here on the button and select the controller you're using. In my case, I have an Xbox 360 controller. So this is the option that I have to select. And it's pretty much done here. Now click on next. And this is it. We have finished setting up the emulator. Now click here on finish and it should open the emulator as such. Now with the emulator installed, we're gonna grab the files required to play this online, and I'll put the link of them on the description of the video, but they were originally available here on the Discord server for OnlineCTR. This is the place where this whole thing was made possible to begin with, and I'll also put the link of this server on the description of the video if you want to find people to play online and also get in touch with the developers of this, and they are available here on the latest build channel. And to play this online, you're only gonna need the online CTR files here from the .zip. The server is only if you want to host your own custom server to play this online. But like I said, the link will also be on the description if you don't have Discord. With the file downloaded, you're gonna have to extract it from the .zip and you can use either WinRAR or 7-zip. That's up to you. I personally would recommend 7-zip. So I'm gonna click on the file with the right button, click on 7-zip, and then click on extract here. These are the files we're gonna need. Only one of these two, actually. This is actually for playing the game at 60 FPS, which is another mod that this community made a while back. And to apply the online patch, we're gonna need the American version of Crash Team Racing, the .bin file of the game to be more precise. And I can't show you here on the video where to go to get the game because this is against YouTube's policy. But it shouldn't be very hard to find this game online at this point, if you know what I mean. And when you have it with you, you can place it here along with the patches as well. This is the game file right here, the .bin. And now to apply the patch, we're gonna use a online patcher that was provided by the same guys who made this online mod as well. The link for this website will be on the description of the video as well. And right here on the choose file, the first option, we're gonna select the .bin of the game, of course. So click here on choose file and navigate to the folder where the game is right here. Double click on the .bin file. And now click on choose file for the patch, of course, and do the exact same thing. And like I said, there are two patches for this one to play the game at 30 or 60 FPS. And there's no reason for not playing this at 60, by the way. There's no issues or anything like that. So go ahead and click here on the online 60x delta file, double click on it. And now with both files selected, this is the new game file that is going to be generated after we click here on patch. So this is what we're going to use to play this game online. So you can go ahead and click here on patch. This will only take a few seconds, and this is going to be saved on the same folder where the original game was. Just make sure that the file name is this one right here, and go ahead and click here on save. Now back on the Duckstation emulator, you're gonna notice that the game does not appear here even after clicking on scan for new games, and that's normal. That's how it is supposed to happen. Because this is a modified version of the game, the emulator cannot detect it, but we can start it anyway. But before that, we have to configure the emulator for OnlineCTR. And this part, you have to configure it exactly like I do here. So make sure you follow everything I show here. Start by clicking here on settings and then click here on console. This window will show up in the settings that we have to select here. Starting here from the top, the first one is enable 8 megabytes RAM. On CPU emulation, change the execution mode to new recompiler experimental. Enable clock speed control. Click on yes, I will confirm bugs without overclocking and stuff. And here on this slider, you have to change the percentage to exactly 400% right here. You can use the keys on your keyboard to be more precise like this, but it has to be exactly 400%. Now on CD-ROM emulation, change the read speedup to 10x and seek speedup, click on it and change it to infinite instantaneous. Now let's head over to the graphics tab right here, click on it, and on aspect ratio, change it from auto to 16:9. That patch that we installed also has a true widescreen patch for this game as well. So this will activate it. This is it for these settings. Make sure you do not change anything else here. So go ahead and click on close. And for the last step, let's just make sure here that we selected the controller right. Click on settings here and then go to controllers. And just make sure that only the controller port 1 is enabled here. The controller port 2 should be appear as not connected. You can change the device you want to use here as normal, or if you want to change individual inputs as well, that's okay if you want to do that. But just make sure that only the controller port 1 is connected here on the emulator. Now, when you're finished, click here on close and we are ready to start the game. So you're gonna click here on system and then click on the first option here, start file. And you're going to navigate to where the patched game is. And when you find it, simply double click on it to start it. I'm gonna do the Sony startup screen, but it shouldn't take long here. And it will stop in this screen right here. So now we have to go back to the CTR online files here that we downloaded before. and you're gonna double click here on the client.ex file. The window will show up, and here you're gonna have to type the name that you want to use it online. This is the one that other people is going to see. So just type whatever name you want here and then press enter. And even though it says waiting to connect, you're likely already in the server. Go back to the emulator right here, and there you go. If you see this screen, that means everything is working as fine. So now you can just select the server that you wanna play here. Select one of the rooms available. Select the character you want to play as. They're all available from the start. And if you're the host of the room, you can also choose the track as well. And finally, you can start racing online. I have many other tutorial videos like this on the channel, so if you like what you saw, don't forget to subscribe and also leave a like on this video and check out my other stuff. Thank you for watching, and as always, I'll see you soon.